own particular chosen plant?
I don't know. You can observe butterflies and plants. They are interacting in your surroundings and compare your observation with referred journals.
Now we observe many butterflies are generally fond of flowers. Are they also selective for their plants or their flowering plants or something else?
Again, that you have to work it on by yourself.
So here the story ends, that some of the these curious students, like while they're roaming around the garden, they saw some butterflies are like fluttering around the plants. So they get like, you saw that, like they get curious, like why are they fluttering around a specific plant or not like anything anywhere else. So at that particular time, a lepidopteran passes around them, and she get come to them and asking the questions and help them to find their answers. So the main objective of the of this video is that, like, we don't know about the we always see butterflies as a beautiful organism, like we click the photographs of them and like stamp collection, like we are using them like a stamp collection, but why don't we know about the biology of it? Like we generally say that statement that all butterflies like, and if anyone ask you a question that why are you able to find a butterfly, they always say that go for a flower and you will find a butterfly. But there is nothing like that. You can find also in a simple plant where the butterfly is not fond of the flowers. So we are trying to find their what is the relation between the plant and the butterflies. So,
okay,
okay.
That's
like we made a concept map of butterflies, like as sir said that we want to show that. Here is the concept map of butterflies. You can. As you can see that the butterfly, that the little beautiful butterfly, it almost cover all the field of biology, and apart from biology, it also have relation with social life of humans. We generally we saw that general public is like fond of butterflies, like and they are attracted towards beauty, so they also come in the like social life of the public, general publics. And in the ecological part they are connected with the many things like plants, biodiversity, and many things and all.
Great. Let's clap for. Okay. Yes. So, for groups who haven't really shared the concept maps, please do share them on the group. Okay, so that we can go through them. Okay. So we'll have the next presentation.
Hello everyone, I'm Arushi Jain. I'm doing BSc Life Sciences from Dayal Singh College, Delhi University. So I have performed a preliminary test to check when photosynthesis stops in different plant species. So I prepared a bromothymol blue solution to check the activity in plants. So 0.01% of aqueous solution in bromothymol blue was prepared, and few drops of one normal NaOH was added to make the solution blue. And then the 1 mL of BTB solution, the bromothymol blue solution, was pipetted out into each falcon tube, and the leaves were placed near the lid of the falcon tube in the test setup, and no leaf was there in the control tube. So this was the first experiment. The first tube is the control tube, which has no leaf in it. And then I placed the mustard and then the spinach. After maybe 12 or 16 hours, it changed the color from blue to green. The mustard and spinach changed the color from blue to green. So it shows that when the respiration occurs in the evening, the CO2 evolved from the leaf changes the color of bromothymol blue, because it forms carbonic acid from the water and changes the color. Similarly, I repeated. It was very dark. So then I diluted it. You can see the color. It's very light. So I diluted it and placed a dark color, black color paper on the peepal leaf. So I want to check if light is responsible or not. So in the peepal leaf, when it was covered with the black paper, it changed slightly. The color was changed very slightly. In the second image, last is people with dark cover.
In the first image, is there a people without any dark
cover? No, there's no people. Then I took a people leaf, but I placed a black cover on it, a black paper on it, to check if there is, yes?
Like a direct correlation would have been if you have taken people not in dark.
Yeah, in the next I did that. So again, I took different leaves again, the petunia, dahlia, citrus, salvia, and cordyline. And I made a mistake again, the leaves size is not equal. First I took very small leaves, but now I took large leaves. So it changed the color again. And in the first image, the petunia and dahlia, the solution is already slightly green. It's not completely blue. First image, petunia and dahlia, on the left. So it's not completely blue, as in the control tube. When it changed the color after 2 hours, it is more green, because the solution was already a little green, light blue. After 2 hours, in the fourth image, petunia and dahlia are green.
So one thing I'll suggest is you keep all your controls always on left side, or right side, because in the first set the control is on the right side, I presume. I have to figure it out. And on the second set the control is on the left side, right?
Left side. Yeah. So we still need to standardize it because of the NaOH.
Once again, repeat that. What happened to the last one? Petunia, dahlia, and control.
That's a control.
Control. So what is that you wanted to tell us?
First I took in the first image. There's a control tube, then petunia and dahlia, but the color of the solution is not that blue in the control. They're slightly green. They're slightly light because...
You are talking about the last figure?
No, the first one.
First one.
From left, the first tube.
Before experiment, I just put the leaf then, and after 2 hours, it changed the color, but it's dark green as compared to the others. So that is because the solution was already less basic. So that is what I wanted to say, that we still need standardization.
Actually, the color change which you see in petunia and dahlia on the right side after 2 hours, that is because they were already when we started the experiment, those tubes already were slightly greenish blue. So yes, they changed color faster. So yes, that gave us an idea that probably the basicity, the pH
is the reason.
Is, important. So if we want a color change fast enough, probably we should make it less basic.
Yes.
So that then we can maybe within half an hour or 1 hour we'll change, see the color change.
Yes. So.
I was noticing that you said that you adjusted the color with one normal NaOH, which is a huge concentration of NaOH. Yeah, but even few drops in one less than 1 ml of solution is huge. So that will take, if the basicity is very high, it will take a long time for it to become green.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah. So that's what I think now you are saying. Yeah.
Yes. So
my suggestion is that make the solution, test solution. No. Yeah. Either dilute or don't make it so basic.
Yes. Yes. Sir.
Yeah. So you can even check it in a pH meter.
Yes. Sir.
pH meter. So my suggestion is that don't use one normal NaOH for adjusting pH.
Okay.
For that small solution.
That was the preparation given in the paper. So we followed it exactly the way they said that we should prepare. So probably that was.
And all that is why this is the results after 2 hours. First two images are before the experiment, and after 2 hours it changed color in petunia and dahlia because they were less basic. After 12 hours, the leaves that were in dark cover, that were covered in the black paper, they are changed to green, dark green, almost dark green. So that is what I want to say, that we still need standardization because it is taking more time to change because it is more basic. So we have to make it less basic for that. Thank you.
Okay, thanks for your presentation. So we would now proceed to the awards function. So Jian, we would proceed with the awards function now. Okay, Arunan, so we will be proceeding with the awards function now. So can you just come on stage? So yeah, even Jian would join us.
You want me to say something? Okay. This is working, is it not? This is working, okay. Okay, so I think it's a, unfortunately it's too late, but it's a very, very pleasant thing to happen. In CUBE, we don't normally give participation certificates. On the other hand, we give lavishly awards for people who show some interest and perseverance and collaboration and things like that, what we have been elucidating in the case of CUBE. So just because somebody has participated, no, we don't consider that to be something worthwhile. No, in the sense you can participate and collect a lot of certificates, and when you give it to somebody, I think they may not also find it very valuable. So here we offer awards. In fact, that's what I said, that large number of awards we give lavishly. Wherever there is a positive thing that we have been seeing it, not only today, throughout the year, or maybe consecutively. So this is what we have been giving. So I think somebody should come and read it out. Where is the list? So this time also, I think people who are familiar with this should know that we have been having several awards, and I think we should give it out. Can you just read it out? Yes, read for the certificates only. So not in any order, I think, probably. You can just read out. And also the certificates we give, when we give the certificates, it's not certificate given to one single person. Most of the time, to the team or people who have been fitting into that bill. So a certificate will contain probably a large number of names. Okay? So one of them will be some of yours.
So as I call out the names, they have to come, right?
Yeah, I think that will be a good idea. So we have enough copies? Yes. Yeah, so sufficient.
So, okay, so I'll just read it. You can just read out the names. So, for example, the first one that is kept here, I don't know whether Mayur had got any order or something, is Collaborative Undergraduate Biology Education D.D. Kosambi Young Scientist Award. So I think you will read it out and yes. Somebody comes and I can give it out or GM can give it out.
Okay, so I'll call out the names. So
you can come
and collect your certificates. Okay, so the D.D. Kosambi Young Scientist Award 2019. The names are as follows. Lydia Matthew.
You can read this also.
Okay. So yeah. So this award, the D.D. Kosambi Young Scientist Award 2019, is conferred on the following CUBE members that I call out for their exemplary contribution to collaborative undergraduate research. So Lydia Matthew.
GM. Okay, Lydia, you can go. I think so. Call everybody.
Okay,
so
let
everybody come. Let it be a crowd.
Okay, so the next name is Arati Pillai.
Stand there.
Shraddha Sonavne. Uday Kumar, Anaga Nair, Arjun Udupa, Kabir Nadkarni, Vivas Nag, Nilakshi Sinha, Harshali Dagde, Rachel Turkey, right? Turkey.
She left. No, she has gone. I think we'll send her.
And
but read it.
Mandar Sawan. Ritam Das. Deven Panchal. Apurva Ghare. Kanishka Parashar. Pooja Dhabolkar, Vaibhavi Bhanushali, Ritik Baviskar, Rupesh Brid, Abhishek Suryavanshi, Sejal Tiwari, Niyati Sevak, and the last is Man Masi Beck.
So everybody. Okay, so why don't we just pass it on to... So give me all the certificates of D.D. Kosambi. This is D.D. Kosambi Young Scientist Award. How many of you know who D.D. Kosambi is? You do a Google search. And GN, why don't you come and give it? This is your... No. Come. You had to be on the stage. Come.
Come on.
So much. I don't have energy to give. From here, left to right.
Left to right. Come on, I am left.
Okay, right to left. Who is the most popular being? Back Benjamin. Oh, that's for me.
You get nothing.
Some more
I'm taking this.
Oh, okay.
You want to say a word?
What is that?
You want to say a word on this?
No, oh, okay.
The people who haven't come.
Oh, people who haven't come. Okay, so T.D. Kosambi, young scientists. Are they looking young? Okay. Looking like scientists. Okay, so next one. Yeah.
How many glasses do you have?
How many glasses, yeah?
I mean,
Specs. Right. They don't look young. When the specs old. So many glasses. Okay. What is the normal distribution?
Okay,
thanks a lot.
Yeah, thanks a lot. Okay, so we move on to our next award. Our next award is Veronica Roderick's Award 2019. This is conferred on the names that I take now, and this is something that is given for perseverance in the pursuit of science. Okay, so the Veronica Roderick's Award 2019 goes to Priti Kanade.
Priti is there.
Siddhant Godard. Kajal Kumari.
Kajal.
Abhishek Singh. He's not there, right?
Not there.
Binita Ghosh. Apurva Satpute. Mahalakshmi. Haripriya Srinivasan, Kunjalakshmi Anil, Shivam Kumar Srivas, Mehroz Khan, Priya Shinde.
Read, because they are sitting there. I just read aloud again.
Yeah. So, Kunjalakshmi Anil, Shivam Kumar Srivas, Mehroz Khan.
So they are from M-Ward.
M-Ward. These are from from Mehroz Khan. She's from M-Ward Learning Center, Mumbai. Again, two more names from the M-Ward. Priya Shinde and Kuresha Ansari.
You can actually read about... Okay. Everybody came?
Yeah, everyone who's present is here. Okay, so
I just wanted to make a comment on Veronica Roderick's, because I worked with her, and so I feel for her. She's no more. She has been one of the very brilliant and very warm scientists in TIFR Molecular Biology Unit. And I think for the beginning of CUBE type of activities, I think she has been one of the inspiring forces, as much as her professor and associate, Obaid Siddiqui. So I think this is given for the perseverance in science. And Veronica was no less in her perseverance and making us work hard. So I think it's a great this thing in memory of award in memory of Veronica Roderick's. And it is for definitely for people who have been persevering for the long time, and including the M-Ward people, where they have been contributing a lot, and even now, after a lot of work they are doing somewhere else for social amelioration of social problems. So,
yeah.
Okay. So I think Kajal, we can give it later. Okay. Okay. So I think I will pass it on. So.
Claps to be loud.
So this is for
I think we have one shot of it.
Yes, one shot.
So I wanted to also read out, did you read out Haripriya Srinivasan and all that?
Yes.
So there are people who are not here, they have not even come, not come. Haripriya Srinivasan, Kunjalakshmi Anil, who else?
Abhishek Singh.
Abhishek.
Binita Ghosh is not here.
Binita went today.
Went, okay. Yeah. She was here, but then it's not available.
So thanks a lot, it's a great achievement, and you don't need a second.
Okay, so thanks a lot.
Being a cubist is a has always been a wonderful part of my life. I'm glad this happened to me, and actually feel many a times that this should have happened much earlier. So that, because I see the young cubists working on different projects, whatever work they are doing it in much better way than we as, like, when I was in college, as college students do. Because as we move from school to college, we are getting into a little rigid mindset that, okay, we have to focus more on this, our schedule, our practicals. But the school cubists, they are like free-minded. You mold them, they will get molded accordingly. So I feel this should reach out, and we all should also keep doing, participating and collaborating this for this.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Thanks for your words. Okay, so we move on to the next award now. So the next award is K.S. Krishnan Student Mentor Award 2019. And this is conferred for exemplary contribution to collaborative undergraduate research. Okay, and the names are Ruchi Modgekar, Harshita Bhanushali, Shubham Mohanty,
Shubham,
Manasvi Dekate, Abhishek Unnikrishnan, and Rishikesh Bendare. Joey, right?
We have enough numbers. So 3 plus 3, 6.
Exact.
Oh, okay.
Student mentor.
Student mentor award, no? So they have been mentoring.
K.S. Krishnan.
Okay, K.S. Krishnan also has been incidentally from TIFR, Molecular Biology Unit, and he has been also one of the moving forces. Okay.
So this is...
He is shy of. There's another DD Kosambi Award 2019 is conferred on the following CUBE members for cultivating scientific temper by remodeling the curriculum at the delivery stage. Cultivating scientific temper by remodeling the curriculum at the delivery stage. Obviously, they must be teachers, is it? I don't know. Everybody is a teacher? Yes, it looks like. Or metamorphosed into a teacher. Yeah? So, butterfly.
Yeah. No, metamorphosis doesn't mean butterfly.
Oh, I see, okay. It can be a mosquito also. Okay, Ashutosh Mule. Chitralekha P. Dyal Singh College. And Seema Das St. Xavier's, I don't think that she has come. St. Xavier's College, Mumbai. And Ananda Tulsi Government College for Women, Guntur. She has left. So I think I should give this three. Oh, we have only two. Ashutosh and, yeah, right. Okay,
thank you.
Okay, now you can take over. Go on duty. Okay, this we'll keep it.
Yeah, you can keep it here. Okay. Okay, so the next award is the CUBE Regional Resource Center Award 2019, and this is conferred on the following CUBE hubs for catering to nodal centers. Okay. And this award. So the CUBE Regional Resource Center Award 2019 goes to Elphinstone College, Mumbai. Shyama Prasad Mukherjee University, Ranchi. So we need one representative.
They are all coming.
Yeah.
And the teacher is also coming.
Yeah, and the third is Sapekhati Higher Secondary School.
Sapepakhi Higher Secondary School.
Assam.
Sapepakhi.
Yeah, here.
And Shama Prasad Mukherjee University, I think they have already left. So that is Ranchi. Mayur sir, in front.
So you can
and you can also go and stand there. So what?
There are just two right now.
So
Ranchi is not there anyway. Okay.
So this is an award I think we have not given earlier for the centers, because now the cube. One of our ideas was that the cube should be spreading all over the country in colleges and schools and research centers, so that some centers will be forming hubs which will be supporting the rest of the groups. And that type of a hub formation is taking place now, very active groups where things are being developed and they will be also passing it on to people. I doubt whether Elphinstone College has been doing that, but they have been getting it from Shama Prasad Mukherjee place. Am I right? You have been getting a lot of things from Shama Prasad Mukherjee University, and I'm sure that you are also passing it on to people here and in different places. And Sapepakhi Higher Secondary School has been one of the most active schools, and I have been mentioning it earlier. They are also part of a program called BLISS. That's how we came across these people first, and then from the Burmese border that they have been functioning, right? Of this side of the border, not on Burma side. and they have been doing extremely wonderful work there, and I'm sure that they'll be catering to the rest of Northeast to start with. To start with from Assam and probably Meghalaya next door. So I think I will be passing on this. Ranchi has been doing, I think somebody has mentioned about it, I think Ranchi has been doing extremely brilliant thing with kitchen lab as well as the college lab, university lab. Okay, so whom shall I give?
Mayur sir.
Yeah.
Mayur sir.
It's all because of him.
All
in there in Elphinstone College, and now you are doing potential hub, is
in
it?
Bhavans in Bhavans College. Potential hub. So we are waiting for.
So don't stay in Elphinstone for long. You have to start so many other centers.
In fact, Elphinstone started with Ashutosh. Stone laying ceremony was done by you. Stone throwing. Okay, next.
Okay, so the last award that we have for today is the Anil Sadgopal Award for Popularization of Science 2019. This is awarded for outstanding contribution to science outreach. Okay, and this award goes to Batul Pipewala Cube Kolkata. She's not here with us.
She must be watching, I suppose.
Yes. So she has been really very active. Recently, she has been almost in, I would say, in every aspect when it comes to popularization of science. She has been there she has been spearheading these kind of activities, and certainly she deserves this.
Okay, so is there all?
Yeah, that's the last.
So that's it. Okay, incidentally, Anil Sadgopal is also offered an award here. Anil Sadgopal started the major program, Popularization of Science and Schooling Program, called Kishore Bharati. Universalization of Science Education. Education and Science. He started in the 1960s, actually. The seeding was in 1960s, and the program started in 1970s. And some of us are all associated. I think even Surjit is associated with that to an extent. So he's being awarded here from the Homi Baba Science Center Award. Okay, so thank you very much. I think we should be, Jay has to say something about it.
Okay, thank you everyone for being the part of the session today. Actually I just wanted to announce about tomorrow. So basically tomorrow, we have the outstation people are staying here. So teachers are also there. Many teachers are there, I think. And we want teachers tomorrow. Yeah, and we want also the students, outstation on both. So basic idea is that I think many of them have touched upon the concept mapping today in the presentations. So we will be tomorrow from the morning till the afternoon, maybe lunchtime or something, we'll be making the concept maps. Curriculum, how your these topics. So now we will be actually making the concept map. In the sense, you have already some